What's going on, guys? It's that time of the week again, time for another box review. But before we start the review, I have a special announcement. We did it, guys. We made it. We finally got big enough that we got our first Magician Jaso imposter. Shouts out to a player by the name of Zero Smith. Zero is clearly a huge fan of mine since he spent the last 48 hours pretending to be me in the community chat rooms on the Line app, and he made his own videos pretending to be me. Clearly a tribute and testament to his unquestionable love and support for me and all that I do for you guys and the AT community. I do have some constructive feedback though from my number one fan. Your impression of me needs quite a bit of work, dude. You got the voice all wrong. And as for the constant day drinking you did to portray me as a drunk, you're gonna have to step it up, man. Try kicking back a few more bottles to reach my level of alcoholism. This gig is tough. The right amount of booze is key. You can do it though, man. I believe in you. But in all seriousness, while I am flattered with your clear love and devotion to me, Zero, I do find it a little concerning that a grown man would waste 48 hours of his life continuously drinking and impersonating a YouTuber online. A YouTuber for a mobile game of all things, no less. So I gotta ask, is everything alright, dude? Do you need to talk to someone? I mean, if pretending to be someone important who others look up to is what you need to do to bring some small semblance of happiness to what I can only assume is a pretty sad and miserable life, then hey, you do you, buddy. I'm not here to judge you. I do care about your mental well-being though, man, and I think you should most definitely seek out some help with your mental health care, which you so very clearly and desperately need. But anyway, since you're such a big fan of mine, let me do you a solid, man. Let me show you what your deck plays like in action. It's the least I can do for you to thank you for your love and admiration. And there you go. I know it wasn't very long, but hey, it wasn't a particularly hard match. Don't give up though, man. Keep working on that deck. I believe in you. And just a reminder to all of you guys watching, if you ever are unsure if you're hearing from the real me or an impersonator, just check on my YouTube channel. It's the main place I engage with all of you wonderful people and the only place I will ever have my videos hosted from. You can also always connect with me on my Facebook page. I post a lot of fun stuff on there as well. The link for that will be down in the video description. Anyways, on to what you're all really here to see. Let's take a look at the Whiskey Nightmare Box and Animation Throwdown. Like always, first up, we're going to be taking a look at the legendary pre-combo card, Whiskey Bartender. Alright, so this is an amazing legendary pre-combo card. This is one of those great utility ones that even once the Drunk BGE ends, it's going to be a great card for you to run in your defense deck for Rumbles, Sieges, the like, at any given time. During the drunk bonus, it's going to be fantastic with that extra boost. Even off the bonus though, it's going to be a staple in your deck if you can get a quad fuse of it. Its attack isn't too special at 10, but it does have an amazing HP stat at 65, on top of which all three of its skills are based around being defensive tanks. You have that beautiful 9 bodyguard there to block punch damage, gas damage, and the like, so you could really help protect not just this card, but any flank cards as well. You also got that 12 sturdy, which will be blocking even more damage to this card directly. So realistically, that's going to put your health wall there above 70 with that. And to boot, you also have that 9 hijack, so crazed is not going to work against this card. All in all, I think it is a fantastic drunk pre-combo. Honestly, I think it's my favorite pre-combo out of all the new drunk ones they're introducing for this round of the BGE. So yeah, it is definitely my favorite legendary power combo card. It's definitely a 5 out of 5 on the card alone there. Now let's take a quick look at the legendary items in the box. First up is the new Brew Beer. This new item card is a pretty good defensive item. You do have the 9 attack, which it's not horrible, but it's not great either. But what's great about it is that 57 HP. It's going to be amazing on defense. Not to mention you have that defensive skill in the bodyguard there. The 9 bodyguard will be blocking extra damage against it from punches and gas, as well as the flank cards. And on top of that, you have 13 leech built into this card as well to help keep it alive if the AI doesn't combo this card right away in your defense deck. So this is a fantastic item to have. The second legendary item in the box, Thunder Cocktails, we've already covered quite a few times in a previous box review, but again to recap, this is the offensive item to have this time around for Drunk. With an amazing 20 attack stat, you just can't compete. The 33 HP is on the lower end though, so I would not recommend running this in a defense deck as that can be taken out in one shot no problem. Skill-wise, you do have the 7 recover though, so on offense, if you don't combo this right away but combo a card in slot 2 or 3 while this is still alive, you can increase your HP of this card by 7 each time you combo. It does have the 7 hijack there, which is nice to counterbalance craze, but again, with a 33 base HP, don't be relying on hijacking too much craze if you want this card to be alive. You're going to want to combo it soon. You do have 11 leech there though, which is nice to try to counterbalance that low HP to try to get back some of the health on that card if it does get hit. And finally, the last item in the box, Vodka Beer. We covered this item in last week's box review, but to recap, this is a great versatile item. It has 11 base attack, which is not too high, not too low, it's right there in the middle ground. Health-wise, it's got 50, which makes it pretty nice on defense. Skill-wise, though, you also got that 7 sturdy, which just adds to its defensive capabilities. So realistically, you're looking at 57 HP, assuming they don't have the jab skill to break through that wall. You also have 9 motivate to other drunk cards, which makes this a fantastic support card to run in your deck, whether it's on offense or defense. And like always, with that 10 cripple there, cripple is always a great skill to have to just either really help you or bug the shit out of your opponents in defense. That's gonna do it for all of the legendary items in this box. Now let's take a look at the characters. First up is Philip J. Fry. Fry is hands down one of the best characters to have in the game of a quad fused of him. Basically, you want to have as many quad fused Fries as you can possibly have. He's great. He works great on drunk. His new drunk combo they just made is fantastic with its skills. Not to mention, he has great combos in almost every BGE, especially come music with his super dance squad combo. So looking at Fry, his base stats, he's got that amazing 18 attack. His HP is on the lower end at 38, which does make him a liability a little bit on defense, but you can risk him sometimes. He does have 7 payback, which is a good defensive skill to have, so if he does survive a hit on defense, you will be dealing some extra damage with that. You also have that 10 boost there, so if you don't combo Fry right away but combo another card, you can increase his attack by 10 each time. Basically, first combo, you're going to make that attack go to 28, which is already phenomenal there, and the more you combo, the better he's going to be. You also do have that 10 shield on there to other Futurama cards, which is a nice, nifty little support skill. You're not going to see much use of that, though, outside of Siege, unless you're running an all Futurama deck, as that shield does only go to Futurama cards. And the other character in the box is one I'm sure everyone is sick and tired of seeing by now since Animal is ending, Klaus Heisler. I know Klaus has been in so many boxes these last couple months trying to hype up Animal for the game. That being said, though, he is a great defensive character to have. His attack is at 4 is just shitty. You're not going to get much use of him on offense at all. But defense-wise, in a defense deck, you do have that 60 HP, which is really nice. And skill-wise, you do have 11 recover. So if you do manage to make a combo down the line, you can increase his health even more. His shield all 4 only goes to American Dad cards, so you're not going to see much use of that outside of Siege, unless you're for whatever reason or another running an all American Dad deck. You do have the 10 gas there as well, so if by some chance you do manage to get your attack off and cause some damage to your opponent's cards, you'll be gassing them too. One cool thing though about Klaus is you can make the PC in this box, the Bartender Klaus, you can make that combo with Klaus, and the combo version will definitely be stronger than that power combo, so not a bad thing to run on defense if you really just want to have pretty much an unkillable health tank on your side. That's going to do it for the characters in the box. Now let's take a quick look at the epic pre-combos. First up is Hangover Nightmare. Alright, so this epic pre-combo, to be honest, it's not that great in my opinion. The 11 attack is just whatever, it's nothing special. The 44 HP is on the lower end too. It does have some really nice skills, but its stats aren't doing it for me. At the free-to-play level, this card might work well for you on defense, but if you're playing anywhere in like a top 100 guild, I would not recommend running this card as 44 HP can be taken out pretty easily by a good guild. That being said, if it does survive the hit, 11 payback is nothing to scoff at. That's a lot of payback damage to be taking. It does also have 12 leech built in, so it can heal up some of its health back there, when it does get its attack off, and you do have the 7 hijack, so you can be blocking some crazed. All in all though, if you have enough legendary cards to run a full legendary deck, I would recommend just burning this for the Watts. But like I said, if you are at the free-to-play level and need a good, kinda tanky pre-combo and you're limited on options, it's not a horrible way to go for you. And the other epic pre-combo in the box is Bloody Mary Zoidberg. This one, in my opinion, is an even worse pre-combo. Like, this particular one, honestly, I wouldn't even recommend running at the free-to-play level. The stats are what are killing it for me. The 12 attack, once again, is nothing too special, and the 38 HP is just way down there for a pre-combo. The skills are nice, but those stats are just killing it for me. For those of you who do choose to run him, you do get that that boost and recover for 9, so you can technically make this card stronger by comboing down the line somewhere, and you do have the 6 hijack built in, which can be good to counteract craze, but again, I just don't like this card and don't really recommend anyone running him, not even at the free-to-play level, to be honest. And that's going to do it for the epic pre-combos in this box. I'm not going to be going over the epic items this time around, as they are the exact same items that we covered in a previous box review. So if you're new to the channel and want to check out my thoughts on those epic items and what you can do with them, be sure to check out that video. I'll be sure to have the link on screen and also in the video description for you to follow as well if you need them. But all in all, a good rule of thumb is if you're pulling from a box, if you're like pulling a box out, you probably just want to recycle those epic items anyways. But yeah, if you are curious on my feedback on them, feel free to check out that video. So my final thoughts on this box. The legendary pre-combo Whiskey Bartender is freaking amazing. It's going to be a great health tank on defense for during the Drunk BG, and even once the battleground effect is over, it's going to be a phenomenal addition to anybody's defense deck, and you can always use it. So that's already a huge, huge plus in my opinion. As for the items, I think it's a really great mix of items here. They're all brand new legendary items to the game for the new drunk bonus there. You have a really good mix. You have one that's a great defensive card, one that's all offense, and one that's a pretty good middle of the ground that can do both. Either way, though, all three can be run on offense if you need it, so all in all, I love it for that as well. Character-wise, it's got the Philip J. Fry on there, which is working huge in its favor for its score there, because Fry is hands down easily one of the most desired legendary character cards in the game, and for good reason. Klaus, on the other hand, while he can be really good on defense, isn't as desirable in my opinion, and there are better characters out there, so that's kind of a knock against it, especially since Klaus has been in so many of the previous boxes. As for the epic pre-combos in the box, I'm honestly not a fan of either of them, and the fact that one of them I think is complete and utter garbage, even for the free-to-play level, is a huge con against it. I really wanted to give this box a perfect 5 out of 5 score, but unfortunately, those couple dings it has against it is enough for me to just not be on board for that perfect score, so I'm going to have to dock off a turd and give it a 4 out of 5 golden turd rating. Anyways, thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please be sure to leave a like. And if you're new to the channel and want to see more box reviews and animation throwdown content, be sure to subscribe. Till next time, guys. Peace.